In this brief video, we're going to show you some research strategies, including tools and tips for finding information for your next research project. Let's begin with reviewing strategies for picking out a topic. You might remember from your information literacy tutorial that it's important to pick out a good topic, something that you're interested in and won't mind researching on for quite some time. If you have a general idea of what you'd like to write on, a concept map can help you narrow in on a particular topic. If you don't know where to start, following a Twitter feed like Harvard Research can be helpful in letting you know what the latest research is going on in the fields. Next, let's talk about strategies for finding keywords. Keywords are really important, as they're how we're going to find all of our information, whether it be in books, journal articles, or other types of data sets. We get our initial keywords from our research question or statement. In this case, we want to determine what the most important words are within our question. The key ideas are health hazards and cell phones. The next step is coming up with as many synonyms as possible for each of these terms. We know not every database uses the same language, so we want to come up with as many search terms as possible. Some of them will be broader, like mobile devices, and some of them will be narrower, like texting, but they're all generally the same idea and might be helpful in our research. For health hazards, we actually have to determine what kind of health hazards we're thinking about. Effects of phone radiation, or something more along the lines of accidents and car crashes. We'll say that we're going with accidents, so other terms for health hazards would be accidents and distracted driving. So now that we have some keywords, we can discuss search strategies utilizing them. We often use words to join keywords. If we use the word and, we'll narrow our search results: cell phones and driving. Another term we use a lot in searching is or, and if we use or, we'll broaden our search: cell phones or mobile devices. So you get more results with or and less with and. So here are our keywords joined together with these searching operators. We've broadened our search with cell phones or smartphones or text, and we've narrowed it by stating that all search results have to have the word accidents in it. You may be seeing some unfamiliar symbols within this search string. The highlighted asterisks are called truncation symbols, and this means we'll be searching for all words that begin with whatever comes before the truncation symbols. For example, the word accident with a truncation will get us words like accident, accidents, accidental, and text will get us text, texts, texting, texter, and so forth and so on. This broadens our search. You can also see there are parentheses in this search. They work the same here as I do in math. You do what's in the parentheses first. So 1 times 2 is 4, plus the first 4 is 8. So if we apply the same strategy to our search string, we'll do whatever in the parentheses first, cell phones or smartphones or text, and then combine that with accidents. You'll also see quotation marks in this search string. These turn the words inside of them into a phrase. So cell phones with quotation marks become cell space phones. Nothing can come in between those two words. Without the quotation marks, it's an and string, cell and phones. And while we know that the word and can narrow our search, using phrase like cell space phones makes it even narrower and only searches for those words in that exact order. So just to review, you can use the asterisk symbol as a truncation tool, and anything can come after it. You can use the question mark as a tool to replace individual letters. In this case, it replaces an A and an E. But beyond these two symbols, don't use other symbols like the ampersand, plus sign, or equal sign. Most databases won't recognize these and will give you no search results. Now let's use our keywords and search strategies we've just learned and apply them in a database. In the first box, I'll put the first portion of our search string, accidents with our truncation symbol, and I'll use our parentheses and quotation marks and put our or statement in the second box. Below, you can see we have lots of search options to add to our search. These are called limiters. Some limiters that you might find helpful include scholarly peer-reviewed journals, which are often the type of articles you need to use for your research papers. Depending on what your topic is, the language limiter may also be helpful, limiting it to English or any other language you read fluently. We can have as many limiters before our search as we want. We can also limit after our search. For example, to the left of our search results screen, I can limit by date. Often, we only want the last 10 years or so worth of research. This concludes part one of our research strategies video. In this brief video, we covered how to find a topic, how to come up with keywords, how to use and, or, and special searching symbols, and how to apply limiters to our search both before and afterwards. Remember, you can always ask any librarian for help or find us online at library.lmu.edu/get-help.